How long is the current follow-up, and could you discuss the updated results regarding the co-primary endpoints, radiographic progression-free survival, and overall survival?
So, as you know, the problem of a co-primary endpoint is that usually you've got the first endpoint and then the second. So, when we released the data last year, many people hadn't died yet. So the curve we showed to the public, they were more statistical construction than real patient. Now we have accumulated more patient, more deaths, and now we can confirm that there is a real overall survival benefit. What you see from the curve is that last year they were touching each other at the end because there was no many patients. Now you can see that with time the curve remained parallel. And this is important because it really shows that the PREVAIL trial is not about enzalutamide placebo. It is about comparing two strategies. Doing what we've been doing for forever, doing X-ray, doing bone scan, and then when the patient was becoming symptomatic to start chemo and all of this. And in PREVAIL, what we do is that as soon as the patient progresses in the castrate, we start the drug. So really we are comparing two strategies. Because what is really amazing is the proportion of patients who have received a secondary treatment. So we really compare two strategies. And the conclusion is, if you start earlier with one of these agents, because that's the same observation with Abby, they live longer. So this is not about a drug. It is more than that. It is about a strategy of starting a very good drug earlier on when the patient becomes metastatic and castration resistant.
And what were the results regarding other endpoints, such as the time to initiation of cytotoxic chemotherapy and regarding the quality of life?
Yeah, the other endpoints haven't changed. They've been published already. There is more than 1.5 years delay in chemotherapy. There is a major benefit on progression. There is a major benefit on quality of life. We will not bring new information because that was already very mature. The quality of life paper will be out in Lancet Oncology in a few weeks. So we confirm that it is not only about starting a drug earlier, it's really offering the patient a longer quality time. Because you give a drug, they live longer, but the time they live is quality time because you delay progression, deterioration of quality of life. So really, what you buy, if I may say, because we're going to have to pay for this drug, what we buy is really quality time. And if you think that a lot of patients are afraid of chemotherapy, it doesn't mean you're going to suppress chemotherapy, but they're going to get chemotherapy much earlier. So really, you buy some good time for these patients.
And what were the main conclusions, and what do the results say about the place of this drug in the treatment of metastatic CRC?
So, really, there are one message and one question. The first message is that when your patient is becoming metastatic and castration resistant, meaning he has metastases, bone or visceral, he has a rise in PSA, he has a low testosterone, there is an overall survival benefit to start with Abby or Enza. Then come the question, if you don't have access to this drug versus if you have access to this drug. If you have access to this drug, really, I believe that should be the standard of care. Abiraterone or enzalutamide. Now the question comes, these drugs are extremely expensive. They cost on general 1,000 times more than the drug we have used before, like bicalutamide, flutamide, dexamethasone, prednisone. So should we use this drug anymore once we have Abi or Enza? That's the Cougar 302 trial. It shows that if you start with an old drug, you have a deficit in overall survival. So clearly the message is, if you have Abi or Enza, this should become standard of care in a patient which is castration and castration resistant and metastatic.
Then I have another question. What's the role of imaging?
I'm a big believer of the new imaging techniques. We can see wonderful things. We can better measure response. We can better see progression in an earlier setting, but we have to be careful. When we use modern imaging, we change the definition of the disease. And to me, it is important that these new imaging test technique, they are tested with the same rigor that drugs are tested. If I have no problem to tell you that you should start enzalutamide and abiraterone earlier, it's because we have 4 trials, 5,000 patients, FDA audited, EMEA audited, I believe this result. The result we have with modern imaging technology nowadays should be taken as phase 2 trial with drug. And before you change the way you treat this patient, you have to be careful. So modern imaging is beautiful but promising.